Hi guys, and welcome to this tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to do advanced sidechaining in LMMS. The first thing you might notice is that my LMMS looks a bit different. That's because I'm using a beta version that's currently in development, and as you can see, we have a really good new theme. Anyway, sidechaining. So most of you guys learned how to sidechain by actually connecting a peak controller down to these little things called faders. But I personally think that's a really bad way of sidechaining, because that does not allow you to mix properly, because these faders are here so you can mix your track. Anyways, for you who don't know, sidechaining is when you have something like a kick. And then whenever that kick hits, you want the sound of some other instrument to go down. So if you play this little demo I put off, you can see when the kick hits that it's not as clean as you would want to. So we fix that by sidechaining. Anyways, for sidechaining, you need a sidechain compressor and a sidechain signal. So your sidechain signal can be your kick, but I don't like doing that because it doesn't give me as much control as I want. So I use a triple oscillator. You just put the triple oscillator on, and this is gonna get loud. You put all the three oscillators to noise. Okay, now you want to envelope that. So amount, just put everything down except for decay, and match it to the pattern of your kick, like this. And now adjust the decay to your kick. You have a sidechain signal. So now add a peak controller on it. So peak controller, okay, done. And now we have a peak controller. On the peak controller, put the bass all the way down and mute it if you're using an external sidechain signal. If it's your kick, just leave it like that. And this is all we need to do with the peak controller. Next, you want to find your desired instrument and add a sidechain compressor on it. It's a cuff sidechain compressor. Add it, okay. And this is the interface. So what you want to do is actually find this knob called sidechain level and connect your previously made sidechain signal to it. So it's under controller one. Done. Now when we play it, you can see sidechain level moving. Now the rest of this sidechain compressor functions as all other compressors do. You have threshold, you have ratio, and you want to keep the ratio as high as possible if you want like really sharp sidechaining. And what's also cool about this is that you can control attack and release on every separate track, so it gives you a lot more control than using a mixer fader. So here we go, let's play it, and you can hear it being sidechained. We can control the release so it's more lazy or it's more sharp. Let's just solo out. And you can hear how the sidechain sounds. So you can play around with the threshold, the ratio, the attack and release, and just make it your own and make it go to the sweet spot. And that's basically it. That's how you use a sidechain compressor to sidechain in LMMS. So thank you for watching, and see you next time.